Wonder Woman.
I remember the Wonder Woman. I remember
your destiny awaits before you.
What an amazing color.
Thank you. I was
Oh my god.
I have the trousers as well, and then I decided not to wear them.
Perfect. Oh my god, and you were with the green thing and the whole thing. We could have been
hatched.
We can sit next to one another
in my bag.
Yes.
I'm the only one that wore purple, which is the actual right color to be wearing
right now.
How
cool that would look if we were sitting next to one another.
Should I sit over there?
Yes, you can interview.
That is a good.
I'll do it this way.
That is a good combo, the blue and green.
I like the blue and the blue.
Yeah.
Cate and Jack, so nice to speak to you about House of the Clock and its walls. I wrote some notes because I am prone to accidentally spoiling things.
Oh, good.
Without meaning to.
Okay.
So I figure if I just read my notes out, I won't accidentally spoil things.
Stick to the script.
Yeah. I like in this that Lewis gets to eat chocolate chip cookies for dinner. I want to know, have you ever actually got to indulge in what we all want, which is dessert for dinner?
There was a restaurant chain in Australia in the 90s called Death by Chocolate.
Mm.
And I went there once and I never went back.
Mm-mm.
Because sometimes I think if you eat dessert first, it's just, you end up throwing up.
Well, the real faux pas but that I have indulged in is breakfast dessert. You know, you go straight to the cherry pie a la mode.
At 6 a.m.
Yes. And it just was, it felt so right. I think that it's actually the right way to kick off the day. And it's not that much different than pancakes with syrup.
I suppose not. But that is, you're American.
Breakfast food does mask as dessert sometimes, I feel.
Mm.
Pancakes and syrup.
I think that Americans really do often eat dessert for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
But I do think if I were going to go to the electric chair, my last meal would be cheeseburger, fries, and a vanilla milkshake, which is very much
You'd
like a dessert.
You want a milkshake before if you got died?
Why wouldn't you?
I would not.
No dairy?
No. I would still have the salmon with the kale salad.
Lactose intolerant?
No, I wouldn't. I'd probably have french fries.
What's the point of being careful on the last meal? Go hog wild.
It's not about being careful. It's about
being basic. Oh, right.
But maybe that's Lewis's magic power,
is that he
can eat as many chocolate chip cookies as possible and not. It's because they're magic cookies.
Maybe I'll ask for the guillotine instead then.
Hmm.
I also like in this film that pumpkins and Halloween is kind of like an overarching theme in it because I'm a huge fan of Halloween.
Me too.
A Halloween banner up in my house at all times. Halloween is coming up in like a month or two. How do you feel about Halloween? And do you have a like favorite costume you've ever worn?
Well, we were shooting in Atlanta over Halloween, and I think I did a really great scary clown.
You did. I remember.
We found the right street. We went up and down and up and down, and my makeup was really good. I dressed my son up as the Joker the year before, which is pretty good. The makeup is very important.
Yeah.
What about you?
Did
you go as Jack Black?
I did. I went as Jack Black. I really party pooped. But Halloween is generally my favorite holiday. Mm. I love to dress up. I was thinking this year maybe I would go as the house with a clock in its walls.
On, you know, and have a couple of, like a little
it's
wheels.
Big. It's
you need wheels.
It's a heavy costume unless I go cardboard version. But I think it would be a good
look.
You
were talking about lumber yesterday.
I think my face would be the clock.
And your kids could kind of go on hands and knees? No.
Who's going to carry
that? They can be the pumpkins.
The pumpkins. Yeah. But the exploding pumpkin sequence in the film.
It's fun.
It was really fun to shoot.
Was it? I'm guessing they weren't real exploding pumpkins.
There was a lot of goop being sprayed. Oh.
There was a lot of imaginary, destroying of pumpkins that were flying towards us.
Mm.
It was a challenging imagination exercise.
But Eli really created that. It was like being in a silent movie.
That would be fun to watch without the special effects, with us screaming
with him,
and
swinging. And then it's vomiting on you from this. Oh, there goes a vomit.
Yeah.
The directions were very specific.
I love when those things are released of like the green screen when the things aren't there. Because I know that it must be kind of torturous to do, but it is really fun. Mm. And I do love that Lewis is obsessed with a TV show / character in this. Because I was like that when I was younger. I was just had full-blown obsessions. Were you obsessed with anything when you were like preteen or a bit younger?
I was obsessed with Wonder Woman and the Wonder Twins and MASH.
You remember the Wonder Woman theme song?
No, I don't.
Wonder Woman.
I remember the Wonder Woman. I remember
your
that.
Destiny awaits before you.
I think you should do the theme tune to the next Wonder Woman. It's yeah. coming out soon.
I was disappointed that they didn't use it in the movie. Oh, my yeah. obsession was $6 Million Man.
And the $6 Million Woman.
They just called her the Bionic Woman. I think she was $5 million.
She was worth, no, she wasn't $5 million. She was like $15 million.
She was worth $15 million, but she got paid less than the Bionic Man.
Yes, she did.
Because it was
did.
the '70s.
Lindsay Wagner.
Yeah, the best.
The Bionic Eye.
That was Bionic Man had the eye. She had the ear. She had a bionic ear. And together they were unstoppable.
Just like this paradigm.
Maybe that could be our next.
Yeah.
Oh, totally.
I'm seeing the cogs working.
Project is born.